begins in a few weeks, and helping kids and families get into the fiesta spirit is nanny expert, lifestyle blogger, and owner of No Other Nanny, Jada Rashawn.
And there really is no other nanny, as the name implies, right? So,
what did you bring for us today?
Well, it's fiesta, so we are going to get very much so in theme. We're going to do a mini pinata.
Okay.
I've been seeing these all over Pinterest, and so I tried them with my niece and nephew, and we're going to make them today.
And we're going to let you in a little secret. Save the boxes when you do all your online ordering, because Jada came here, cut this thing up, and that is going to be perfect for that.
Yes, so save your boxes, because you can use the boxes from Amazon or where have or whatever online order you purchase you've made, and you can cut them up and make any type of themed animal shape, whatever. We're going to try to make a SA Live themed mini pinata. So all you'll need, you're going to need basically a cutout of the shape or the animal that you'll want, which is what we've already done. We're doing a circle because our logo is a circle. We'll cut it out. You want to have two of those, right? And then you want to cut a strip of cardboard as well, because you're going to need to create a border around that shape. So that's what we're making here with our circles. So you'll want to use either hot glue or just scotch tape or
Elmer's glue,
whatever. Mm-hmm. We're using tape so that you can secure both the borders. It doesn't matter if it's going to be messy, because we're covering it up with our tissue paper. Mm-hmm. What you'll want to do with the tissue paper is what Fiona, you're doing right now. And you'll want to do the back as well here. And if it's messy, it doesn't matter, because at the end of the day, we're putting, you know, little special little prizes inside
of
the pinatas.
Like it would be, even though it's small like that, kind of a tough pinata to break through.
You know, it is. So we create a small little opening. This is not going to be your traditional classic.
And what do you put in your pinatas?
I like to switch it up and make little surprises. So I will do candy. I will do some treats for the kids. I'll also do things like money. Mm-hmm. I'll do little fun little notes.
You got to make some noise too. And I want to make
on that
a maraca,
okay.
Right? So we've got these eggs. And you get those at the craft store,
Easter
right?
eggs that you had over Easter that you did the Easter egg hunt with. I know we've got a ton of those still laying around.
Yes.
So you'll just open up the plastic eggs, put the garbanzo beans. I actually like to use different types. So you can use garbanzo beans. You can use rice. You can use black-eyed peas. Just go into Target or into your grocery store and get some of the dry grains. All you're going to do is, one, you can close it up, and that's your maraca. Shake it. Okay, so that's very simple and a fun way to repurpose your plastic Easter eggs. And then another way is, if you want to have handles, I'm going to have you hold this one.
Okay.
Isn't it cute? It's like a little holographic fiesta-themed looking egg. And just take two spoons, and we'll secure it with, we'll try to secure it. Look at Jada.
Here, let me go like this.
All right.
Okay.
So we'll secure it with some washi tape. You know, washi tape is my favorite. And honestly, if the egg wasn't cute already, I would take the washi tape and work my way all the way up and cover the entire egg with washi tape. But now we've got our musical instruments that we can make.
And if you want to wrap some tape around there too, just to make sure that doesn't fall off and
that's
have
true too.
Spill the beans all over the place. But
spill the beans, exactly. Hey, look, when it comes to fiesta, you guys can make, we can make a song, we can write our own song.
And that's what you said you do for some of the kids that you nanny for, is write a little bit of a song.
We'll just make a whole band.
Because
we're a whole band.
Not only is it creative with this and the good motor skills, cutting out and things like that, but gets a little noggin working too.
It gets them working, it gets them being creative, and you can have fun. This is a great way to have the kids hands-on with everything. If you have a nanny at the house, this is an easy craft for them to do with the kids over the summertime, and it's perfect timing for fiesta.
Right. Wonderful ideas.
Thank you, guys. Fiona, you did good, girl. And you can cover the border too as well, but we got that. That's cute.
Thank you. Look at that.
And there then stuff it up with the stuff it up with candy if you like to as well. And that's our fun little piano. You can also attach string to it too.
And
if you want
more information on Jada and No Other Nanny, just head over to SALive.com and click on the As Seen on SA Live tab. Thank you, dear.
You're so welcome.